We found ourselves at a strange period of time between Yom HaZikaron and Yom HaTzmud. Every morning when we finish reading the statements of Rabbi Yishmael, so the last one is the one we are most likely to hear. V'chein shnei chesuvim hamachishin zed, yad sh'yavo chesuv ha'shlishi v'yachir b'neihem. That you have, oftentimes you have two different psukim that seem to contradict each other until you have the third one, which, you know, explains the difference between them. So I saw in the Dvar Torah from my chaver, Rabbi Jay Kelman, that a lot of times we have these sort of contradictory situations in Judaism, Yiddishkeit, contradicting principles, and it's sort of hard to distinguish between them, and we have this period, light is light and dark is dark, but then there's now, right? Then there's Bein HaShemashot, right? Sort of in between. We don't know, is it day or is it night? Sort of the confusing time period. And it points out that, Yom Kippur, so it was chance for the Jewish people to do tshuva when God sort of forgave them for the sin of the golden calf. So on the one hand, it's a celebration and it's a Yom Tov. On the other hand, it's also a day of trepidation and fear, or what is the judgment going to be for us this year? And so there is that tension. And we do some feasting and some fasting after Yom Kippur. We do the feasting before and then the fasting on, but the day itself is a Yom Tov, but it's also a day of trembling, so we have that tension. Or if you think about Purim, in Purim we go from the fast of Esther, which is a day when we weren't sure, things were in the balance, what was going to happen, the time of battle, and it's remembering Esther's fasting when we weren't sure whether what the decree was going to be, there's destruction going to come, and then you move directly from the fasting straight into Purim, into the celebration of the fact that we were saved. And here with the closeness of Yom HaZikaron and Yom HaTzmaut, where you're thinking about the great losses and remembering those who have sacrificed for the state of Israel. And then you move from one day and you go into the next, and now it's a celebration, and we're celebrating Yom HaTzmaut, and it's the same sort of thing where we're moving from one to the other. And we in this world, in this life, there's a lot of both. There's a lot of things that seem dark and a lot of things that are great light. And we have to live with both, and we have to make distinctions and say, okay, well, now we're going to stop. There's a sadness, but the sadness needs to stop. Now it's time for joy. And it's more, we certainly feel it stronger on these types of days where we make it such a strong distinction. But of course, our lives are very short anyway. We have joy and we have sadness. We try to do them at the proper times, and sometimes, moving quickly from one to another. But certainly we pray for a time. We live in times where we're lucky to have many wonderful, fantastic things, including a state of Israel. If you would have 70 years ago, they would have told you that Israel would be 9 million people and, one of the most successful economic and military countries in the world, you're crazy, you're crazy. But we live with these amazing miracles. Of course, we also live with, missiles raining down and with all of the tension and the darkness and the inability to achieve peace. And we live with those, both those tensions. So we pray for the day will come when there will be Hakatzav HaShlishi, that will be Machriya Beinehem, that Kadosh Baruch Hu will show us the time of the Geula, and the time we'll be able to see all of the Nisim and the Flos in an open way, and the light will be able to shine clearly for us. But until then, we have to do our best to figure out how to sort of thread the needle of Bein HaShemashot and how to live with the tension of both of these situations. Come on, man.